Let me first introduce our great presenter here today. He's the general manager for Essaterra in Bulgaria. We have there this great distillery, and he is an amazing person with a lot of scientific knowledge, and also in the distillery industry, he is very, very experienced. You know, we have a lot of oils that we distill, like lavender, melissa, rose, frankincense, myrrh, chamomile, juniper, peri, and so on. He prepared for you a great presentation so you can have a better understanding how does distillation work. So, Plamen, we're all ears.
The usual question at the beginning normally is who we are. And for those from you who don't know and it is new for you, we were established in 2015, and we built and opened the first part of our distillery in 2016. So our history is not that long. We are, of course, 100% owned by doTERRA. That was the first owned by doTERRA distillery built outside of the United States. And maybe some details, interesting facts. At the beginning, doTERRA told us you're going to distill only lavender, only for 1 month. And even before we started with the lavender at that July in 2016, we were already distilling melissa. So it was clear for us from the very beginning that this is going to be something larger than only lavender and only for 1 month. And one and a half years later, doTERRA asked us to take over the resin distillation. We started to work all the 12 months, and because of the length of the distillation process of the resin, which is sometimes up to 100 hours, you will see later, we are forced to work 24/7. So we don't have we actually shift our team in a way that we don't have holidays. And the demand of frankincense resin is so large that we cannot afford to have a break. In the meantime, we have three production units with over 38 stills, and our total capacity measured in cubic meters is over 224. Why Bulgaria? It is maybe a logical question for most of you. What we have in Bulgaria and what makes Bulgaria unique from the point of view of an essential oil giant as doTERRA are a couple of factors, maybe mainly three factors. The optimal geographical and climate conditions. That means that in the small country of Bulgaria, we some of our scientists counted over 130 essential oil plants, and so the possibilities are huge. Second important factor for the development of the distillation business in Bulgaria is a long years tradition. Over 170 years, we have distillation since 170 years in Bulgaria. We distill rose, which is quite a complicated distillation because of the very, very small yield and the huge volume and amount of manual work needed to be done. You know, we will come to the roses later. And the third factor is the professional equipment made in Bulgaria. Everything, all the techniques, all the machines and equipment in the A distillery of Essaterra is made in Bulgaria, which is very convenient for us because on other places on the world, I know for sure, most of our colleagues are struggling with the problem to buy an equipment somewhere in the world, and then in case something happens or for maintaining this equipment, you need specialists, and they are far, far away. I can tell you that the company built our equipment is 15 minutes away from our distillery, which means that we are very spoiled, directly to say, with any small problem or improvement suggestion or whatever, we can have a specialist right away around the corner. This is this gives us the freedom to look for improvements constantly all the time, and maybe this is one of the reasons for our success. And I look forward for the future. It is very relaxing for me as a manager to know that my team can be let dream as much as they want, and their technical dreams can be realized very, very fast. Let's go to the oils we are distilling or we have distilled in the future. Our main oils are, of course, lavender and frankincense. I don't know if you're aware, Bulgaria at the moment is the largest producer of lavender oil in the world. There are over 100,000 acres, or over 10,000 hectares of lavender plantations in the country, which that was created in the last maybe 10-15 years, and in the last 5 years since we are on the market, the production of lavender is stable, the quality is constant, the prices are acceptable for each part of this business, for the farmers, for us, etc. Lavender is an important oil. Of course, the second largest oil we distill is frankincense. These are 10,000 of kilograms of oil we distill every year. For those who had the chance to visit us, maybe you remember the large warehouses we have with all the raw material, all the resin coming from the African Horn, from Somaliland, from Ethiopia, and the countries around. We have enough frankincense for at least 2 years work if something happens with the deliveries, which we are sure is not going to happen. The third important oil for us is Melissa. Melissa is a very delicate plant. For those who doesn't know, Melissa needs to be handled very carefully. It needs to be distilled right away after the harvesting. We introduced Melissa in Bulgaria and are happy to. I can tell you a small story. Maybe 5 years ago, doTERRA started to look for Melissa, and the best offer we had from a dealer of Melissa oil in Bulgaria was less than 1 kilogram oil. In the second year after we started with Melissa, we produced and supplied to doTERRA over 1,000 kilograms. At the moment, we are over this amount. Melissa is a wonderful oil. I don't have to tell you this. And we are proud to be the only Melissa supplier for doTERRA. Yarrow is an important oil for us and for you, as far as I can see the sales results. Yarrow Palm is one of the great examples for success, combination between yarrow and palm, and this is a great product. All the yarrow comes from Bulgaria. It is a blue oil, as you of course know. It is hard to be distilled. This is very sticky and very delicate. We are happy to deliver this to you. Rose, of course, is the queen of the oils, as they used to say. Later in the presentation, you will see, but rose is a complicated oil, is a tricky oil, and of course very expensive because of the very, very small yield. Mur is one of the reasons we still, of course, we will come later to Mur, but Mur is a very interesting from the distillation point of view oil, because at the beginning of the distillation process is a light oil, so it flows over the hydrazole, and then in the second half of the distillation it turns to heavy oil, so it's under the hydrazole. You have to separate it from the bottom of the separator, and this process is not described in a single book. We have to invent this. And we are happy to do this because this complex of the light and the heavy oil brings you the health benefits, and all the molecules are on the table. This is interesting. Savory is, it was for a short time 2 years ago a single oil in Europe. Maybe you remember this. Now is for sure in several blends and recipes. It is a traditional plant for Bulgaria, very interesting and similar to lavender. It looks like a lavender, but the smell is totally different. Chamomile, we used to distill another blue oil, and the oils we source and supply to doTERRA, but we are not distilling juniper berry, zdravets. This is a kind of geranium. It is in the DDR prime, as far as I know, and the Rose Absolue. In general, we have two kinds of distillations, so steam distillation, which means that in the vessel, in the distillation, still on the left side of the picture, comes only steam, no water, only steam, and the steam comes into the still from the bottom. The still is full with raw material, is well pressed, and then the steam takes with it the oil from the places where the oil is in the plant, and then it goes up in through the pipe in the condenser, in turns to mix of oil and water, and then in the separator you separate the water, the hydrazole, from the oil. And the second kind of distillation is a water steam distillation. That means that you practically boil the raw material. This is the classical distillation for all the resins and the rolls. That means that you fill up the still with water, you bring it to boiling, and then you put the raw material, and the rest of the process is the same. So through the condenser in the separator. We use natural gas for our boilers. We're happy to have this. This is a very effective, cheap, and environmental safe energy source. That important for us because we are a large distillery is this consistency of the steam, and I'm convinced that you can achieve this only with, or on the best way, with the natural gas. Esoteric distillation technology around the globe. Nice sentence, but as a member of the doTERRA family, of course, we were asked several times to help improve the processes in other countries where other oils are distilled. And I'm very happy to be able to do this. And our equipment made in Bulgaria, plus the technology, is in distilleries in Kenya, in Albania, on Hawaii, in USA, in Pennsylvania. You can see which oils are distilled with our equipment: eucalyptus and thyme and oregano and tea in Kenya, also cinnamon bark soon in Albania, the helichrysum, some lavender and laurel leaf, and maybe juniper berry on Hawaii, of course, the famous Hawaiian sandalwood, and the project in Pennsylvania with the birch bark is running, and it, as far as I know, is quite successful and will start very soon. We helped to create, we tested the most of these raw materials in Bulgaria, and then we gave our ideas and our inputs and advices to the colleagues how they can improve their processes, and of course we supplied the needed equipment for this. Except in Pennsylvania, I was personally on all the places, and I can tell it's very, very relaxing to see how all these oils are coming out of the separator. It's a great pleasure. Of course, I mentioned several times, and we are very proud. Our rose project in Bulgaria, the name of the company and the new equity there is Terra Rosa. Maybe you don't know, but in the heart of Bulgaria, quite exactly in the center of the country, we have a valley which we call the Rose Valley. 100 years ago, the people found out that in this place, the Rosa Damascena, this oil sort of rose, is growing very well. And they started to plant it and to distill it. And we found a place exactly in the middle of this Rose Valley. And the distillery is ready. We will be able to distill after 1-2 months when the campaign starts. This is a picture, maybe 2 months old, and there are much more improvements in the meantime. But from the technical point of view and distillation point of view, the distillery is absolutely ready. The plot there is almost 11,000 square meters big. The more than 1/3 of it will be planted with roses. Once the situation in the world allows, everyone is welcome to visit us. You will be after a year or two, you will be able to pick up roses and then directly to help us distill it a couple of meters away. And it is not a big distillery, 4 stills with 5.5 cubic meters capacity each, which is quite enough. And it was in Facebook. I don't know if you were able to follow this, but 1.5 months ago we were able to distill roses already. Last summer we deep frozen quite a quantity of rose petals, and 7 months later we distilled it. It was a test for our equipment and also for our team. And I can tell you that very unusual for February in the middle of the winter. Everything smelled like roses around. An exceptional picture and event for us. Very happy to have done this. Now we know the distillery is working. Opening is now in May. Opening is a big word. There will be not an official opening, of course. We will just start distilling and hope that this COVID situation goes away finally, so that we can accept guests at our place, and we will be very happy to have you there. Last year or the year before, I don't remember exactly, but maybe it's still available. But we are extremely happy to have this Bulgarian floral collection from doTERRA, our emblematic, our big and important oils from the country, lavender, melissa, and rose in the Dutch version. That was a great honor for us, and I can tell you that I have this on my table. I am afraid to touch it, and I don't allow anyone to touch it. It's just as a symbol of our work. Lavender is, we call it an easy oil because you have quite a normal yield from 100 kilograms of lavender. plants, you have 1 kilogram of oil. The distillation takes 1.5 hours. It's a steam distillation. We're used to do this. We distill over 50,000, about 50,000 kilograms of oil each year. So it's okay for us. Melissa is a little bit different. You need 2,500 kilograms of raw material for 1 kilogram oil. The distillation is not much longer, 2.5 hours. It's again a classical steam distillation. And for the rolls, you need 3,500 kilograms of petals, sometimes up to 4,000 kilograms, and it takes again 2.5 hours. It's a water steam distillation, and just imagine almost 4 tons of rose petals hand picked early in the morning between 6 and 10 o'clock before the sun starts to shine very strong, and it has to be wet. The petals have to be wet, then you achieve the best yield. And it takes really, really a long time to pick up, to harvest 3,500 kilograms petals. I can tell you that from 1,000 square meters rose garden, for all the campaign, for all the 20, 25 days, you get approximately 500 kilograms petals all together in total. So it takes a lot to have 1 kilogram of rose oil. Imagine 5,000 kilograms lavender flowers, then you get out 50 kilograms essential oil. That means these are approximately what you see there on the pictures. These are approximately over 3,000 bottles, 15 ml bottles. And I often ask my colleagues to think in bottles, in 15 ml bottles, not in kilograms, in buckets or in drums, but in bottles. And for them is totally impossible to think this, because these are millions of bottles under the line. The situation with Melissa, of course, at the end, after the 5,000 kilograms raw material, what you approximately see on the picture, you get, of course, only 400 bottles, 5 ml bottles. You saw the reason before, and for the rolls, you get approximately 255 ml bottles. This is our deep frozen project. I told you already. I forgot that it's on the presentation, on the picture on the left. This is how it looks like after 8 months by minus 21, 23 degrees Celsius. And what I have in my hand in the glass is the result, approximately 1.1 kilograms of oil. Right after the distillation, it was a funny experience in February. So far about the oils, but for us to distill oil for doTERRA means also to have a core impact in the community. We are for our area in Dobrich, this is the largest town in the northeast of Bulgaria, we are an important factor. You can see how our employees, our job position increased in the years. We started with 6 people 6 years ago, and now in the summer we are over 250, 260 people. Our contracted farmers, of course, 2015 zero, we worked with 60 people at the beginning, 60, 65, and now we are at about 200 farmers. That means that we impact the area. It is an agricultural area, we are very happy to be one of the companies which supplies a constant income for our partners, which is our main target. We will come to this maybe later. And of course, the other important role we are playing here is our contribution to the greater good, as they call this here. You know, of course, the Healing Hands Foundation of doTERRA, and through the years, in the last 5-6 years, we donated over 300,000 euros. Actually, we didn't donate it. You donated this, and we are very happy to be the instrument in the hands of Healing Hands. And I can tell you that we made a lot of people and children especially happy. We managed to go through all the sectors where something urgently is needed. Of course, our focus are children. Our focus are orphans. Our focus is the situation of people who cannot be a complete part of the society. That's how, where we see our role. I don't want to go in details. Of course, if you're interested, on our homepage is enough information about this. But again, we had the privilege to be in contact with very nice people through the years, and we donated everything possible, from tractors, as you can see on the pictures, over cars, and we improved. We actually rebuilt it one of the orphanages here in Dobrich, health centers and gardens, and it is an endless list. And actually, I always hear thank you, but actually the thank you belongs to you, because through your sales, the Healing Hands Foundation can exist and can help further. And I can tell you that in Bulgaria and in our area, Healing Hands is a well-known name, and the people know us even more with our donations than with our distillation activities, because the distillation activity is a limited occupation. So to say, you saw we're working with 200 farmers. If you multiply this by four of normal family, this is less than 1,000. And with donations, we made really thousands of people happy. And here I have to say thank you to you. I'm open for any questions.
So there's a question. We would love to have Bulgarian rose collection again. Does doTERRA plan to offer it again? I am still amazed. I have them. It's from Irina. Yeah. Maybe I can answer that. Is that that was a limited time offer?
Yeah.
And limited time offers might come back or might not. So we cannot confirm it at the moment. Let's hope for it.
Yes.
Let's just hope for it. The oils are absolutely there. What happens with the floral
water?
What from the plants?
Yeah.
I can hardly read it, this question, but probably you get it.
The floral water, the hydrosol. Actually, maybe here is the time and the place to explain the difference. It's a simple difference between a hydrosol and the floral water. The hydrosol is the water which comes out from the separator after the oil is separated. You cannot separate the 100% of the oil. It always remains a little bit in the water, and that's why you call it hydrosol. A floral water is a normal water with where you add oil by purpose. So what we have in our distillery is a hydrosol. And the official answer from doTERRA, this is a very often asked question, and the official answer is that in order to offer the hydrosols to the clients, you have to stabilize it. It is without a stabilization, it is a very the shelf life is very short. So, but in, there are different ways to choose a way to stabilize the hydrazole. And in order to do this with alcohol or with UV waves or with other materials, in order to do this, you have to know before the application of the hydrazole. And the applications are thousands, hundreds of applications. And this is the reason why doTERRA is not offering yet hydrazoles, because it is not only for our, for example, if you stabilize the hydrazole with alcohol, you cannot use it on your skin. And I am sure that everyone who will have a bottle of hydrazole will apply it on the skin. And if there is an alcohol drink, it's a problem. It's a problem. So it's a long way with the hydrazole. I know everyone wants to have it, but for the moment, this is the situation.
Okay, makes sense. How many people do work in Esoterra?
I mentioned it in the presentation. During the campaign, we have over 260 people working for us. Over 100 of them are fixed employed. The rest are seasonal workers. But our seasonal workers are, we employ them in somewhere now in April and keep them until October. So it's quite a long season, 5 to 6 months.
Okay, lovely. Yeah. There was a question also about the transportation. So if the resins, the frankincense resins and myrrh, don't they lose some kind of efficiency or their better part by transportation from Africa?
Of course. Everything which is harvested and not distilled immediately after the harvest loses oil, but in the case of the resin and also in the case of other wooden oils like sandalwood or cinnamon bark or birch bark or something like this, the loss is not that big. So it's insignificant practically.
Okay.
But of course you lose.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. The question is also about visiting Esoterra. I mean, I know it's special time, so let's not talk about the pandemic situation. Yeah. But let's see if there is not a pandemic situation. What are the options for someone to go and personally experience it other than the incentive trips?
Yeah, actually, there is no other way. It was a long conversation between us and the sourcing in Utah, and finally 2-3 years ago we decided to have only organized trips. So all the people should go through the event teams. I know you have an event team in doTERRA Europe or to doTERRA headquarters, and then asking and applying, and they will organize an incentive trip. You should understand that, especially in the case of Esoterra, it is a heavy industry. We are working with hot surfaces, with a lot of trucks and people around, and it is dangerous. Every trip should be organized, and we take our time, of course, when the trip is organized, and you will have the most. So me personally, in the most of the cases, I'm leading the groups. We go through all the production places and then to the laboratory offices, etc. It is better to have it organized and not by coincidence. And so you can imagine how many questions we receive daily, especially in the summer months. And I think this is the best way to have only organized visits.
Yeah, that's absolutely understandable. Yeah.
You will get the most out of it.
Yeah, guys, let me type an email address to you right here. It's euevents@doterra.com. And I hit enter now. So now you all can see this email address and you can now copy it. So please make sure you copy it with you. And if you would like to participate in an organized trip or something, then please send an email to this email address. But please note that the distillery is not able to have individual visitors. So having one or two people, we cannot do that. But what we can do is that if you, for example, tell them that, hey, I have, I don't know, like 50 people, and we would come from, I don't know, from Italy or from whatever, Poland, whatever, then the events team is going to look at it and might, you know, might be able to find a way to get you. It's not guaranteed, but we'll do our best. So don't write emails to Esoterra, because they have to say no. That's an agreement with doTERRA. But with the EU events team, there might be a chance. Okay. Is this fair enough?
It's... If I may add something, the events team is in contact with us, and we together can choose the best moment. Sometimes we have inquiries in October to see a lavender. Unfortunately, it is impossible. The lavender is only in July. So when you have an organized trip, you will be placed in a special moment where you will be able to see the most of our activities.
Okay. It's mm-hmm. highly appreciated. Well, thank you very much, Plowman. And that's all the time we had with him, but we highly appreciate that you were here with us. I think this was a very interesting presentation.
Thank you very much.
A lot of people heard these things for the very, very first time. And I hope we can hear you also maybe in the future.
Of course. Welcome.
You always share with us very interesting things.
Thank you very much, everyone. Bye.
Have a lovely day.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. See you guys.